Tap your neighbor, say, welcome to the school of power. Acts chapter 1 verse 8 said, but you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and you shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the earth. Christianity can never be sweet without power. What separates us as believers from other religion is the power of God at work in our lives and at work with us. The only reason why Satan will fear us is not because we are beautiful, it's because we are powerful. That's why the only legacy Jesus left for us after his resurrection is the legacy of power. The legacy of power. It is risky to call yourself a Christian without power. And every genuine encounter with God's power turns you into a wonder to behold. Like I said before, if your life is at a particular level that you think you are better than, it's because you lack the power to move to the next level. I have said before that nobody fulfills destiny by chance. Nobody fulfills destiny by chance. You fulfill destiny by choice. What defines the sovereignty of God is not in the bigness of God, but in the power of God. And every child of God that wants to rule and reign on earth must be able to exercise power at three different levels. Three different levels. Number one is the level of exousia. That is the power that gives you self-control. At new birth, every genuine encounter with Christ, when you surrender your life to Jesus Christ, gives you power of control over your life. It gives you power to restrict yourself and to restrain yourself from doing the things that are against the knowledge of God. The first time I gave my life to Jesus Christ, and the first thing that I discovered that confirms that I have actually given my life to Jesus Christ was my ability to say no to the life I used to live. My ability to reject the things that I used to do. That was the first clue that I have been truly saved. Before then, I have given my life to Jesus Christ several times. I will take it back. Maybe when I lost my job, I will go to church and they will preach and I will give my life to Jesus. By the time I get a job, I need my life back. Say, so I will take it back from him because I need to return to my drinking. I need to return to carrying women. So I will take it back from him and continue with my life. You know, over a period of time, after I genuinely encountered salvation, I discovered that I was able to do that because I have not been thoroughly born again. I have no power of control. The Bible says, he that has no control over his own spirit is like a city without a fence. It's like a city without what? A fence. Anything can come in, anything can go out. You can be invaded. And that is where many believers are struggling. They actually don't have control over the way they live their lives. There is a force from the pit of hell that always push you to disobey God. And that force works through your emotion. It tells you, you know, there are people who claim to be believer that they cannot do without sex. They cannot do without it. That I have seen believers, ladies who were saying that, this one, don't touch yourself before you get married. How will you know if the man has the size that can satisfy you? How will you know if the man has the capacity to drive you? A lady said, I want to test his, I have to test his, the gig of his RAM. How many RAM does he have? How many gig of his RAM? You know, in computer, there's what called RAM. That is what drives the system. So 16 gig, 10 gig, 12 gig, 8 gig, 4 gig, 1 gig. Praise the Lord. Now, how do we know? Because if he cannot drive me, I will cheat on him in marriage. That is why I have to test the man I want to marry before. Now, I begin to look at, and if you look at the value system in the society today, if you look at the social media, by the time you scroll about 5 pages, you will see where they are advertising sex enhancers. How many of you know what I'm talking about? They will be selling, if they're not selling herb, they are selling syrup. If they're not selling syrup, they are selling what again? They are selling tablets. And they are saying, if you cannot satisfy your woman, if you cannot satisfy your woman, if your bowler is not strong enough, if you want a big bowler, praise the Lord. And you begin to hear all manners of nonsense. It tells you that our value system for family and marriage has collapsed. Ladies, now their primary concern about who to marry to is about who to have, you know, how to enjoy sex, who to enjoy sex with. The value of raising a godly family is in the background. The value of, you know, a good life. Are you getting what I'm saying? Having a good life, leading a successful life as a family man, as a family woman, as marriage is now driven to the back. Sex has now taken the front line in the decision of who to marry. Praise the Lord. Don't be deceived, young lady. Don't be deceived, young man. If you are getting six pack because you want a woman to accept you, then very soon, when you get married, the problem of life will make you to forget that six pack. The six pack will become one pack before you know what is happening. If you are looking for a man to satisfy you in sex, and that is what influences your sex, in your choice of marriage, of a man to marry, then very shortly you will discover that there are more pressing needs than sex when you get into marriage. Are you getting what I'm saying? What am I saying? The problem is because we do not have self-control over our lives, over our appetites, over our desires. When you get born again, the first thing God gives you is ability to regulate your life. Ability to control your life. Ability to know what to say no to and what to say yes to. Ability to refuse what is wrong and capacity to accept what is right. The Bible says faith does not only teach us what to receive. Faith also teaches us what to refuse. The Bible says, by faith, Moses refused to be called the son of Pharaoh, and he chose the affliction of Israel over the pleasure of Egypt. By faith, he refused. So when you become born again, you exercise authority to refuse what is wrong and to accept what is right. You exercise the authority. You have the power to say no to the demands of the Potiphar's wives of this world. The power to reject the offer of Nebuchadnezzar, the king, to say, bow to me, bow to my image, and I will exalt you. And the power to say to Nebuchadnezzar that, oh, live forever, King Nebuchadnezzar. We will not bow to your image. The power not to bow. The power not to bow so that you will not burn. That you prefer to burn than to bow. That is the power of God at work in your life. As a believer, you exercise the exousia. That your boss is offering you promotion for sex. Or sex for promotion, and you are able to say no. You are able to say no. Like Joseph. How many people have the capacity to say no to the pressure of sin? How many people have the capacity to refuse to give in to the inordinate demand of your boss? As a married woman, your boss is winking eyes to you and asking you to sleep with him so that you can have your way in that office. How many of you can say no to that? If you have not been able to reject that, then you do not, your salvation is in question. If you have not been able to reject bribe, are you getting what I'm saying? Then you have no power. You can't claim that you are born again. Because the Bible says in Ephesians chapter 2 verse 2. The Bible says we were once dead in our sin. We were dead in our sin. In which you once walked according to the course of this world. According to the prince of the power of the air. The spirit who now walks in the sons of disobedience. So when you see yourself walking in disobedience with God, you are under the influence of his spirit. And the name of that spirit is called the prince of the power of the air. So Jesus is not your Lord and but your personal savior. Because when Jesus becomes your Lord and your personal savior, he gives you the power to reject the offer of the devil. That was the power God, Jesus used against Satan. After he finished his fasting and prayer at temptation, Satan went to Jesus and said he knew he was hungry. Of course, that after fasting, the next thing is that you'll be hungry. And he wanted to take advantage of his hunger. There are many of us who have fallen to the hunger of this life. That Satan has taken advantage of the things we are going through to actually trap us. And Satan said to Jesus, he said, if you are indeed the Son of God, turn this stone to bread. And Jesus said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceed out of the mouth of what? Of the Lord. And he said no to him. Do you know that power that made him to say no to Satan was exousia? He was able to exercise authority over his appetite. I am hungry does not mean that I should tempt God. When a man or a pastor begins to use his influence over the members that believe him because they believe God called him to begin to get wealth to himself and to begin, hey son, come here. The Lord said, you should sow a seed, a prophetic seed of 100,000 consecutively for the next 14 days. That as you come, you lay it at the feet of the apostle, and I lay hands on you with one man to per day. Yes, sir. Because he already calculated a Venza that he wants to buy. So he called 5 people like that. Thus says the Lord, turning stone to bread. Are you getting what I'm saying? He doesn't have self-control. He becomes a victim of his own appetite. Satan took him up. He said, look, the entire world belongs to me. He said, I will give it to you if you bow to me. I will give it to you if you bow to me. And Jesus said, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. Get thee behind me, Satan. That is exousia. How many of us have the exousia? Number 2 kind of power is kratos. Kratos is defined as mighty power. Mighty power. The ruling power. This is the power that is needed for you to take your place in destiny. This is the power by which you reign on earth. The Bible says, he has made us kings and priests unto our God, and we shall reign on earth. We shall reign on earth. Kratos kind of power, the second level of power, is the power that gives you dominion on earth, that enforces your dominion over Satan, that puts you in a position of rulership, that makes you to exercise authority over circumstances and situations. When you are operating in Kratos, you become a master of circumstances and situation. You are in charge. You are in dominion. You see, you can't be in dominion without the power of God at work in your life. Our dominion mandate cannot be established without an encounter with the Kratos. I repeat, our dominion mandate, which we see in Revelation chapter 5 verse 10, the Bible says, what's our dominion mandate? And he has given us, made us kings and priests to our God. And we shall reign on earth. That is our dominion mandate. We have a mandate to dominate. We have a mandate to rule and to reign on earth. We have, every child of God carries a ruling mandate, a dominion mandate. But that mandate cannot be enforced without Kratos. That mandate
of ruling in your life cannot be established except you have an encounter with Kratos, the ruling power. It is called the mighty power of God. You know, Jesus said to them in Acts chapter 1 verse 7, he said, will you at this time restore the kingdom back to Israel? And Jesus said, don't expect to rule in the kingdom, to have the kingdom back without power. He said, and you shall receive power. Power to reign on earth. Power to rise and not fall. Power to live and not die. Power to fulfill your destiny. Power to get married. Power to have children. Power to do good and to prosper is what is called Kratos, the mighty power of God. Jesus said to them, tarry ye in Jerusalem, Luke 24 verse 49, until you be endued with power from on high. The reason why many are under the influence of Satan, they want to rise and they cannot rise. They want to become somebody and they are struggling with that is because they don't have encounter with the Kratos. If you are living less than your actual status, you need Kratos. If you are struggling to achieve something and you cannot achieve it, you need Kratos. Enusa kaya brahande rusa. Said, until you be endued with power. When Peter did not have that power, the Bible says he was challenged by ordinary mate. And Peter said, me, I have never met Jesus. Who is Jesus? Am I drinking kerosene? Who is Jesus? I don't know him. But when the power came, the Bible says he stood, the same timid Peter, stood before the crowd and said, men and brethren, we are not drunk. Don't give us a name that is not our name. And he lambasted them that Jesus, whom you kill, you murderers, is by him that we are doing all these things. And they said, men and brethren, what shall we do? Then at this point, they arrested them and took them to the authority. And they said, choose, never preach in the name of Jesus again. And Peter looked at senator, senate president, Ahmed Lawan, and looked at speaker, Femi Gbajabiamila, and looked at all the escorts of the National Assembly, and said, reason it out yourself. Think it for yourself, you mumus. If it is right in the eyes of God to obey you or to obey God. He lambasted them and walked away from them. Why? He was in charge. Hear this. If you are not in charge, you are in shame. It's either you are in charge or you are in shame. Many children of God are in chains. They are held down by fetters and irons of the devil. Because they have no power to say no to the devil. They come down in the dream. They tie you easily. Anytime they come with rope and tie you down easily. In fact, when they are coming, you already move your hand like this. You don't give them trouble at all. A lawful captive. A lawful captive. You can't say no. You can't hold me down. That power is what you need. If you want to reign in your family, If you want to reign in your chosen field, you need an encounter with that power. That power. You need an encounter with it. It was that power that Jesus was given after 40 days fasting and prayer. In Luke chapter 4 verse 14, let's look at the scripture. The Bible says, and Jesus returned from his 40 days fasting and prayer in the power of the Spirit into Galilee. And there went out a fame of him throughout all region, round about Ekanarusia. He returned in the power of God, and his fame went abroad. The power announced him, connected him, spoke about him, because he returned in the power of Kratos. By the time Jesus was driven to the wilderness for 40 days and 40 nights, he was receiving enablement, supernatural power. And by the time he returned, there was no media. There was no tabloid. There was no social media. But the Bible says his fame went about. There is a power that announces that without advertisement or billboard, your fame is all about. There is a power that connects. I am praying for someone today that in the name of Jesus, may you receive grace to meet the requirement for Kratos. Amen. Shout a louder amen. Amen. See the way you are shouting amen. You are not desperate for it. This power answers to desperation. This power answers to what? Desperation. Have you seen a pregnant woman? That the way the doctor tells her, oh yeah, gather your strength. This last push, you have to be strong. Then she will gather all her strength because of desperation. She's in pain, she's in labor, and she wants to be relieved because she will gather. She push, and the baby comes out. The moment the baby comes out, all the pain disappears. You are in pain because you are not desperate enough. There is a power that announces a man. There is a power that puts you in position of authority that makes you to rule in your atmosphere. That is the power the witches are looking for. That witch you are selling market with in that market. That's the power they are using. Power, securing it from diabolical means to control the system. That is the power you need to break free from the ancestral curse in your father's house. That is the power that sets you free from every limitation around you. When you don't have that power, you are limited by forces of darkness. The power to reign. Some are not married because they lack that power. The day you contact the power, every anti-marriage yoke in your family breaks from you. I'm telling you. The day you contact that power, that your job is secured. It is that power that opens you up for encounter with favor. It is that power. And it answers to desperation. It answers. The first one, exousia, makes you to do the will of God with ease. It gives you the power to do his will. Thy will be done. But the second one, kratos, gives you dominion over devil. It enforces compliance. It compels the elements of the earth to obey you. David said, as soon as they hear of me, they will obey me. He said, strangers shall hear my voice and fade out of their hidden places. As soon as they hear me. He said further, in Psalm 18, he said, a people I have not known shall serve me. I love that. He said, they don't know me, but they will serve me. Why? As soon as they hear me, they will obey me. Why? I am operating in Kratos. I have Kratos. I have Kratos. I am in dominion. Every time you see a man who is not tired of standing in the presence of God, in the night praying, is looking for Kratos. Every time you see a man who goes to retreat as if he's going to, is taking a stroll, is looking for Kratos. Can you imagine how lazy we have become in the church today? That how many times did you go to retreat? How many times did you even fast? Have you fasted without a general fast of the church? A cry, a yearning for expression. A yearning. You can't be lazy, spiritually lazy in this kingdom and become anything significant. Even grace does not answer to lazy people. Jacob was lazy. And until he was lazy, the Israel in him did not come to manifest. Until he fought for it. So when the angel said to Jacob, what is your name? And he said, Jacob. He said, no, your parent made a mistake. Your name is not supposed to be Jacob. Your name is Israel. He was carrying the Israel on the inside. Why the world knew him as Jacob. But when he got to the place of power, the Bible says he wrestled with the angel. And he changed his name. By the time he went into the battle as an individual, by the time he was coming out of the battle, he came out as a nation. It is an encounter with Kratos that brings the nation out of you. That is why if you are lazy as a believer, you will live the life your enemy wants you to live. You will eat the food the devil wants you to eat. You will marry the wife the devil wants you to marry. You will marry to husband the life wants you to marry. You will be a victim of circumstance. Are you getting what I'm saying? You see, that is why being married to the right person is not a choice you make with sense. It's a choice of this. It's a product of spiritual choice. You get what I'm saying? You don't make a choice of who to marry because of your statistical calculation. Are you get what I'm saying? There is a man you are meant to fulfill destiny with. There is a woman ordained for you to fulfill your destiny. You need an encounter with Kratos to be able to identify this person. Power. Power. How many of you are tired of the present level? Lift up your hands. You are tired of the present level. Now listen to me. If you are tired, then you will pack your bag one day and say you are going to retreat. You think I like to wake up when others are sleeping? You think I like to wake up when others are sleeping? I don't know how to sleep. One of the gifts I have in life is the gift of sleeping. I have gift to sleep. If I impart you with grace to sleep, you can sleep for 7 days and not wake up. Or you see, I said, God, take this grace to sleep away. There is no hardly a night I will spend a night without standing in the presence of God. It is very hard. So when I pack my bag and say I'm going to retreat, and maybe you see me disappear for 2 weeks or 1 week, I am looking for power to fulfill destiny. Power to fulfill destiny. You have to be a mountain lion to be a city dominion. A mountain lion to rule in the city. Do you know how many years David spent from one wilderness to the other before he could emerge as a king? He was anointed king at the age of 17. He started reigning at the age of 30. For 13 solid years, David was jumping from one cave to another. A king living like a pauper. Why? God was taking him through a journey that will make him last as a king. By the time he came out as a king to reign, he reigned. And the Bible says his reign was without end. His reign was without end. Generational impact is not possible without an encounter with Kratos. Generational impact. Saul could not transfer his royalty to his son. He died with his own heir apparent. But David transferred the royalty, the legacy of royalty, to his sons and his children. Why? This was a man of encounter. In Psalm 66 verse 1 to 3. Psalm 66. Is it Psalm 63? Or Psalm 66? He said, my soul thirsted for thee. Psalm 63, please. My soul thirsted for thee. Look at David. Look at David. He said, O Lord my God, early will I seek thee. My soul thirsted for thee, and my flesh longed for thee in a dry and a thirsty land where no water is. That means he was a man of dry fasting. No water. Not to talk of food. What am I looking for? To see thy power and thy glory, so as I have seen thee in the sanctuary, I want to see you in my life. The way I have seen people share testimony, I too want to share testimony. So he sentenced himself on several occasions to dry fasting. To dry fasting. See, Jesus said, this kind goeth not out except by prayer and fasting. There are this kind situation you are going through that will not bow to anything apart from fasting and prayer. Jesus was driven. You know, God called him his son when he came out from the river after baptism. He said, this is my beloved son in whom I'm well pleased. Hear him. Now, somebody could be comfortable with that. When God said that, he gave him a Kratos. For as many as received him, to them he gave power to become the sons of God. Now, he gave him exousia, but no Kratos. When he came out, he said, now, you have exousia, power to live right, but you don't have the power to fulfill destiny. Now, the Spirit of the Lord drove him. Now, the Holy Spirit drove him. The Bible says, and he was led by the Spirit into the wilderness. One would have thought that after God said, this is my beloved son, the Bible said the Holy Ghost descended on him in a bodily form. One would have thought, okay, everything is sealed, concluded. But God said, no, that's not enough. That's why you see some people, they are righteous, but nothing is good about their lives. They live the right life, but they are not experiencing the right thing. Because they have the power to live as sons of God, but they don't have the power to fulfill destiny. You see a sister committed but not married. You see people committed to God, but nothing is happening in their lives. You know why? They have not encountered the Kratos. The enemy is not as powerful as you think. It is an encounter with power that you need. The day that power comes in contact with you, the devil will see you and run. The Bible says, from afar, Jesus appeared and demons were crying. Hey, thou son of God, have you come to? Now, when you appear and there's no reaction, something is wrong. When you appear anywhere, and systems are not rearranged and reorganized, there's something is wrong. Your appearance should make some people to sit tight. Narabashata. I had a secretary one time, was an Ogbanje. She ran away from my office. You know, I went to retreat and I was coming back. She told Pastor Charles there. I said, where is this girl? He said, she has packed up. He said, she came to meet me. I said, I can't stay in the office. Especially when I want to enter this office, something is always, there is a hot in that office. Hot. Hot. She ran. She ran. I don't pray. And it's when we're still raising our children, and then we used to hire house help. I would say, okay, pray. Let us pray for her and do deliverance. I said, no, you don't need deliverance. What will deliver you is here. Come to my house. If you stay for 1 week and you are comfortable, that means you are okay. About 2-3 occasions, some of them don't spend 3 days. 1 week, 2 weeks, the stronger one, spend 2 weeks. You know what happened? After a few days, they just pack. In the morning like this, my wife will go and drop the children. He will just come. Just meet them with their bag. I want to go. What happened? Did anybody offend you? No, I just want to go. I'm okay. I want to go. I want to go. Wait now. I said I want to go. You know why? When you take communion in my house for 2 days, all the fill of the terrible spirit in you will begin to deal with you. Take us here. Take us out of this place. 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 Take us out. I said, so I don't pray for house help. He said, and let us conduct deliverance for her, that the spirit in us will take. What kind of nonsense is that? Come, then burn you. No, it's true. There is Kratos, the power to reign. I pray for you today. That the ability to reign in life, receive it. Amen. The Bible says, and Jesus returned in the power of the Holy Ghost, and his fame went abroad. Someone is under the sound of my voice. As you return from this service today, you are returning in the power of the Holy Ghost. Amen. I didn't hear you louder, amen. Amen. Your fame will go abroad. This is the power you need for divine connection. I pray for someone, the helpers of your destiny, that you have been missing them or they have been missing you. As you leave this service, because you are in contact with the Kratos, I command them to meet you in the name of Jesus. Saul was looking for his father's ass. But when he encountered Samuel, Samuel said, as you depart from me today, the ass of your father, which you have been found, finding, they will be found. I decree in the name of Jesus, whatever you have been looking for in life, whatever you have been searching for, but you have been missing, from this place, as you depart from here, you will find that miracle. Amen. You will find that job. Amen. You will find that connection. Amen. Can I hear your believing? Amen. Amen. The man your destiny is appointed to marry, as you depart from me, Samuel said to Saul, as you depart from here, what you have been looking for will be looking for you. I prophesy that the miracle you have been looking for, that you have been missing, from today we'll be looking for you. Samuel said to Saul, he said, as you depart, you will meet three men. And when they come into your life, they will favor you. They will give you 2 out of the 3 things they have. I pray for someone here, by the Kratos of God, the power of God at work in my life, the mighty power, as you depart from this meeting, you will meet helpers of destiny. You believe that? Let me hear your loudest say amen. From today, you will not meet the wrong people again. The Lord himself will order your steps to the right places. He will order your steps to the right man, to the right woman, to the right people at the right time. Shout a louder amen. In the name of Jesus. He said, they will salute you. That is honor. I prophesy to someone that where they have insulted you, where you have been forsaken, where you have been assaulted and insulted and have been called nobody, after you departing from this place, people that have reproached you, they will honor you in the name of Jesus. So I will make you eternal excellency, a joy of many generations. I prophesy to someone. I am operating in Kratos. That is why I'm praying for you. I am operating in the Kratos. I have the authority and the audacity to bless people, and they will be blessed. I stand in my office as a servant of the Most High. I decree the story of your life change for better from today. Everyone under the sound of my voice wondering about life, wandering from one end to the other, living a confused life, confined into confusion, after today, as you depart from here, your destiny will find direction. Your life will find direction. He said, go to the village at the other side of the village. You will find a cord tied there. Loose him and say, the Lord has need of him. If anybody asks you, wherever your miracles are tied, wherever your miracles are tied, your miracle husband, your miracle wife, your miracle children, your miracle cars, your miracle houses, wherever they are tied, by the order of grace upon my head, they are loose in the name of Jesus. From today, what belongs to you will not go to another. Shout a louder amen. Every miracle that carries your name shall not be given to another. In the name of Jesus. Anderusia brehinda kosa. Anikati manika shanda rabasoto. Erusa brendosi kandivrahanda. I pray and I prophesy that as you return from this service, that people that should remember you will remember you. Everyone appointed to remember you for good, to help you become what God has called you to become, but has ignored you and forgotten you, by the order of heaven, they are compelled to remember you. They are compelled to favor you. In the name of Jesus. Anayabosha. There is a woman here. The Lord asked me to tell you, the doors that were shut against you last year, July, Iraboshia, the Lord said in 7 days before next Sunday, those doors will open you invitation. They will open for you again. In the name of Jesus. Every embargo that has been placed on your marriage, embargo placed on your destiny, embargo placed on your career, saying you will not rise beyond this level, I prophesy those embargoes are removed. If you are here, let me hear your loudest say amen. The embargoes are removed. The embargoes are scattered. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Arimana kayaba sente lemosh.
Lift up your two hands, everyone under the sound of my voice. Everyone bound by Satan from going forward, in the name of Jesus, be loosed. In the name of Jesus, be loosed. Alebadakaya brohosatanabash. Ebraneko tanibrahanda kanabosia. Everyone locked up in prison houses. Every destiny. Every marriage. Every work. Every career. Locked up in prison houses. I command, be released in the name of Jesus. Oh shana rabaseke de prohosia. Rona da kambo shiane katoza. Everyone operating under a curse. Lay your right hand on your forehead. Everyone operating under a curse. The curse of life. The curse of the law. Parental curse. Ancestral curse. Generational curse. I command that curse broken. 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 In the name of Jesus. Hear this. Just this morning, my PA invited somebody 2 weeks ago, and she started coming to this church 2 weeks ago. She was here last Sunday. And she was with, he was with her at the workplace. They were colleagues at work. With her last night before everybody went to our house. Nothing was wrong. She was still working, talking, a young girl. And they woke up this morning. She slept and did not wake up. And one of the colleagues called him and said, this lady refused to wake up this morning. I'm talking about this morning. That people were already crying. She was cold. Dead in the night. And she stayed in my office. I mean, he stayed in my office because it's my PA. And he began to pray that I call on the God of Grace Man, the God of Life Embassy of this commission. I recovered the spirit of this lady back to life in the name of Jesus. I recover her spirit back to life. Wake up. So 5 minutes after he finished the prayer, he received a call that while he was praying, the girl jacked up back to life. Who told you that the resurrection power is asleep? Lift up your right hand. As I pray to your right hand, get home. Be careful who you shake on your way. Don't shake anybody. Get home and lay those hands on those certificates. Lay those hands on every project and anything that you want to be alive. I decree, by the resurrection order, receive the resurrection power. Everything dead in your life, every sick, every business, Anuta, Kepanusia, Rota, Kanabosia, as you lay this right hand on that thing, they come back to life. He said, this sign shall follow them that believe. In my name, they will cast out demons. And Ibrahim Kanosia Manakataj. Lift up that right hand. Anahyabana Katashia.
every curse in these hands, that it will not prosper. I don't know who you are. That curse is broken. Whatever you lay these hands upon shall prosper. In Jesus' name. You will lay it upon the dead, they shall come back to life. Dead business at your laying hands, they will come back to life. Receive the Kratos. Receive Kratos. Somebody shout, I receive Kratos. Mighty power. Wave your hands to the King of Kings. Can you lift up your voice and just praise him? If you have any sickness in your body, lay your right hand on that body, on that place. Right now, the sickness will go. The sickness will disappear. Elohim Adonai. Elohim Adonai. Elohim Adonai. Is a change of story. Somebody's story just changed. There is a change of order. The order by which your life has been run before now is changing. You can get married. You can have your children. You can build your own houses. You can now have your own cars. You can now have your major breakthroughs. Come on, shout a little amen. Shout a thunderous amen. In Jesus' name. Give Jesus a big hand and please be seated.